But ladies and gentlemen, the weather has been very kind, and Red One is starting the full show. Formation is Red One Squadron Ben Murphy. We know him as Baz, and he's a former Royal Air Force Harrier pilot, having served on 1, 4 and 20 squadrons. Like all of the Royal Air Force Harrier pilots, he's seen several operational tours in Afghanistan, supporting the young men and women of the British forces out there, but also those of our coalition allies, who work obviously in some very trying circumstances. This is a 9-arrow formation here, 9 red arrows in the shape of one big red arrow, to use the words of my predecessor Andy Robbins, who also watches the show here today. As they roll out, the smoke comes on and you watch them fly past in a 9-arrow. So Red One calls him in the correct arrow. In fact, I should tell you that Red One is a very keen kite surfer and runner, but also that he has the best fancy dress costume on the Red Arrows. It's a rather fetching Barbie outfit. And unfortunately, we've had to see him wear it 3 times this year already, and it's enough to make a grown man cry. Okay, this is cracked arrow formation turning in towards us now. If you take a look at the left wingtip, or the lowest man as we look at them now, you can see Red 9, Flight Lieutenant Simon Ray, known as Kermit on the team. He sounds a bit like Kermit the Frog on the radio. And it might be because he's originally from New Zealand and flew with the Royal New Zealand Air Force before joining the Royal Air Force in 2002. So let's hear him out of the arrow. Formation there, display pilot, and also a very experienced Harrier pilot, being a weapons instructor on that aircraft type, one of the most demanding frontline jobs. The team now have formed Delta formation. As they turn in towards us here, they're flying at about 400 miles an hour, and the aircraft are just 6 to 8 feet apart, or metrically speaking, that's 2 to 3 meters. So they've got to hold their positions really accurately. So ladies and gentlemen, this is Delta formation. So that's Red One calling the team to Diamond Formation. Now this is probably the most famous, never heard that word before, just made it up. This is the most famous formation that the Red Arrows fly, the one we're best known for. And this is a special year for the Red Arrows in 2010, because this year we have the first ever female Red Arrow pilot on the team. And normally they get a cheer from the girls in the audience. So if you wish to cheer, you'll be cheering for Red 3 Flight Lieutenant Kirsty Moore, who sits just to the leader's left-hand side, so just above him as we look at them now, as they reverse into a left-hand bend in Diamond. Now, Kirsty is the daughter of a former Tornado GR1 navigator, and it was her father who inspired her to join the Royal Air Force to be a pilot. She used to watch him as he served on 27 Squadron at RAF Marham, got the idea about flying from him there. At the moment, though, she's in Diamond. Support to the young men and women of our coalition allies on the ground there. Now you see before you Tango formation, one of the most demanding formations the team flies, believe it or not. These two straight lines that make up the T-shape mean that the smallest areas in position are visible to us here on the ground. So as they run past us here now, they're actually making a very good job of it. Let's see, watch Tango formation. Yeah. Arrows. Side Arrows are a formation aerobatic display. So it's right that I tell you a little bit about how they do the formation flying. All of the pilots are holding their position with reference to the lead aircraft alone. So they're all looking at red one at the front, continuously. That means they only get to see their wingmen out their peripheral vision, or the corner of their eye, and that drives an awful lot of trust between the pilots. You can also imagine that if you were with one of the pilots to the side or the rear of the formation, you have aircraft between you and red one, making it all the more difficult to see him to hold your formation reference. So we put our more experienced pilots in those positions. And one of those is Red 4, who's at the back right of this formation, which is Apollo. In fact, he's the highest man as we look at them now. And that's Red 4, Flight Lieutenant Dave Davis. Dave is known as Horse on the team, and he's our Welsh representation, having been born in Corwin Bay, North Wales, where he grew up, going to Bryn Elliott School. And he's a former Tornado F3 pilot, one of the aircraft that provides the UK's operational air defence alongside the Typhoon, and formerly the Falkland Islands air defence as well. He's also been a flying instructor on the Hawk at Orient Valley and the 2008 Solo Hawk display pilot, where he actually displayed here at Jersey. At the moment, this is the Apollo Twister, tightening up here with the 4G, red, white and blue smoke, making you feel very bullish as you watch Apollo Twister. Very shortly, very briefly in that move there. Now the next formation shape is Blackbird, named after the US Air Force Strategic Reconnaissance Aircraft, the SR-71 Blackbird. It's a large, wide formation shape, which you'll see formed shortly, therefore very challenging for the pilots. And the highest man, as we look at them now, will form the left wingtip of our Blackbird, and that's Red 5, Flight Lieutenant Zane Sennett. Zane's a very charming man, and last year I used to joke on the commentary that he was the second best looking man on the team. After me, of course. But it turned out, as a spectator told me at the Bournemouth Air Show last year, that I'm not very good looking at all, and I was ruining Zane's summer. So I won't make that joke anymore, and I'll simply tell you he's a very accomplished pilot, having served on 4 operational tours with one squadron by the Harrier GL9 out in Afghanistan. I'm making all his work here now with Blackbird. For me, our most patriotic, flown with red, white and blue smoke. Ladies and gentlemen, in respect of the sacrifice of the people, this is the victory roll. And at the back of our Spitfire formation with his white smoke on, providing the fuselage tail, is Red 7, Flight Lieutenant Dave Montenegro. Known as Monty. And with a name like Montenegro, you're probably not surprised to hear that he was born in Bogota, Colombia. But he came back to the UK at the age of 1 and grew up in Beckenham, Kent, where he went to Elaine School, in fact, that's in Dulwich. Yep. Having joined the Royal Air Force to be a pilot, he was a flying instructor at RAF Valley, the place where we teach our new fast jet pilots how to fly jets. And he later served on 25 Squadron at RAF Leeming, flying the Tornado F3, again providing UK and Falkland Islands air defence. He's his second year on the team this year. And he's synchro too, so we're going to see a little bit more of him in the second half of the show. Now this is a Phoenix formation, the widest formation we fly. It's 100 metres, or about 300 feet between the two outside aircraft here, Reds 8 and 9, so they've got a real job staying in formation. As the leader rolls, they not only have to roll with him, they have to match his angle of back, they make big power changes and climb up the same a long way to maintain this beautiful Phoenix formation. But a lot of the accomplished Harrier pilots on the team again several tours in Afghanistan for Planky before coming to the Red Arrows here, and he's in his first year with the team this year. So as we complete the first half of the show, ladies and gentlemen, this is Chevron Formation. And he also has the most embarrassing car of all the Red Arrows. It's a triple, that's the MX5, where he claims it's his wife Amy's car, but we just have to leave him. Here we go. Fly. 5 on the right, 2 and 4 on the left, and we need to get them back to where they should be. So this is the clever part of the slalom. And to do that requires complete trust and coordination between those 5 pilots. Well, it takes 6 months of grueling winter training to reach that level of trust and skill between the pilots to be able to display at a site like this. 5 times a week to be able to do that. Well, ladies and gentlemen, with the red, white and blue smoke, there are Ian as they complete the slalom. Upside down in close formation, while 8 and 9 bow all around their front tires. 8 and 10, slide forwards, all 2. That's the end of the tournament, when it rests in slow, he's got to do the last one. So the inside pilots barrel all tightly around those on the outside and shuffle up to fill the gap. The autopilot pilot car is continuing to stay there, driving roll as hard as they can. That's the power of the break. 8 and 9 are barrel rolling around, 6 and 7 are now spot rolling. Get ready for the amazing Jimbo break. Keep those cameras ready. The engineer aeroplanes, they provide all of the PR. So on the left, Pablo represents the blues. On the right, Monty represents the reds. This is our tribute from the reds to the blues. Watch double rolls. The finale of the show, the fix and break, ladies and gentlemen, the very patriotic, the very British.